watching the very first edition of On the Record with Sunetra Choudhury, and my guest today is the president of the Punjab Congress. Well, I say the president of Punjab Congress, but he's in fact resigned after the 2009 election verdict. Now, the reason we have him on the show today is because it's just the CWC meeting choosing Sonia Gandhi back as the Congress president has just happened. And out of all the people that were there, one of the people who really spoke their mind during the consultations that led up to the CWC is Sunil Jakhar. And so we want to speak to him to get a real insight into what's happening in the mind of congressmen today. Sunil Jakhar, thank you so much for speaking to Hindustan Times. I know that in the end, on Saturday, apart from the, you're not a member of the CWC, but it then became a larger consultation process where various state heads and MPs were spoken to. Tell us some of the things that happened on Saturday's meetings, which perhaps haven't been highlighted as much in the public yet.
First of all, let me first wish you all the best for a new show that you're starting with HT on the political aspects of the society today.
Thank you.
Yes, it was a broader consultation process. It was not just confined to CWC. I think it started first, they wanted to brief people about what has happened in the parliament, how this whole abrogation of 370 has been done by the BJP, and how the whole constitutional process has been kind of vitiated in a way which has very serious consequences. And I think it's a kind of a shot across the bow. BJP has put every minority on a kind of a notice that tumhara number bhi lagega. Now they have shown these people in Jammu and Kashmir their place. Tomorrow may be Northeast. Next could be anybody. It's just a matter of the way they have gone about. Obviously, one has to agree that they never made any bones about it. They were nothing hushes about it. It's part of their manifesto. They have been saying it. But there are ways and means of doing something. I personally think that what differentiates India from Pakistan, because we both got independence, they got on a day earlier, we got on the 15th. What is the basic fundamental difference between where we are and where they are is we have a rule of law. We have a constitution which the country adheres to. And they have a rule by the brute force, or either is the uniformed force or otherwise. We are a democracy. And I think to kind of a just, I would say this is an illegal aspect aside. I think this should have been done in with a broader consultation. And the way they went about talking Vajpayee ji and everything about the insaniyat and Kashmiriyat, that's leave these two aspects aside. They said Jamhuriyat. Where is the Jamhuriyat in it?
Yeah.
The Jamhuriyat has been let go by, and that is our concern.
I want to speak to you about what's happening in your party, because that is quite dramatic.
Yes, our party is going through difficult times.
Yeah.
That's a fact. You can't be an ostrich and hide from realities. This is a tough times, and I think tough times called for tough measures. The going gets tough and tough gets going. So that is it. And I think Rahul ji decided to step down, taking more responsibility. That's becoming of him. And but then I personally think I'm trying to say it because the kind of noises or the voices are coming up that is more kind of dynastic thing going back to. But in what aspect can we accuse Congress party of being a dynast or in what? The idea about being in head of a party is, I think all these, whether it's in the states or looking at the national level, head of a party, like a head of a Congress party, is basically seen as a stepping stone towards the next step, which is the prime ministership, or in the state is the chief ministership. And if they were after power, hankering after power, or trying to grab and keep everything in the family, how do we ignore the fact that Mrs. Gandhi let go when the prime ministership was offered?
But she wanted retirement.
She
stopped meeting all of
you. Yes, she had
stopped. Then why? Doesn't it show the bankruptcy?
Not bankruptcy. It shows the seriousness of the situation. It is a serious, it's a very unprecedented situation. And it called for unprecedented measures. And I think
but the BJP is now going to say, you go back to one shot.
BJP can keep on saying.
You can go back to family.
BJP kept on saying when Dr. Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister, it was always held, the Gandhi family was held accountable. And that's one of the reasons I gave in the CWC. I said, if we think that Rahulji stepping aside would take him off the their sites of the BJP, they will still come after Rahul Gandhi, because this is somebody whom they are scared of. This is like falling into the trap. They would have had somebody else. And what is the need of the RAs to carry the party along? There are desertion people.
Isn't she a reluctant president now, though?
This was said about Rahul Gandhi also. He was a reluctant politician.
I
think he came in and I think he has made a mark. I think people are the opposition, or the government now, they are scared of him. Everything, the whole government is focused on Rahul Gandhi. Why? You remember the time, I think that was the tipping point. Like, he went through a tough time. You remember his speech in Berkeley University, he went to California. That was the tipping point. All of a sudden, you see everything, 54 ministers of the NDA government, including the BJP head and the Prime Minister, went gunning after him because they saw a threat in him. And the threat still exists because he has worked it, he has earned his respect. And I think he has proven himself to be a morally responsible person, which is lacking today. Nobody wants to give up power. He has given up power. So how can you put these things together? They are not hankering after power. They have earned this respect. Mrs. Gandhi is not something which has been handed to her on a platter. This is a virasat, jise kehte hain, is a will which has been written in blood and sacrifices. So they have earned the respect. They carry this. She has carried herself with a dignity. I think she has earned the respect across the political spectrum. Maybe they find it difficult.
That's what you call the RPG?
Yes, RPG is...
Something you said at the meeting.
Yeah, I said because... I had asked Priyanka ji personally, I said, I know he's a very headstrong person. Once he has made up his mind, he doesn't go back. That goes to his credit. He makes a decision. Once he has made his decision, he sticks. He listens to his heart. He's a very emotional man, which is very rare in politics these days. And he stands by his ideals, his principles. And once he has made up his mind, but still as a last resort, I asked Priyanka ji, because I've seen the body language, I've seen the bonding between them. And I said, maybe he will listen to you, because with the logic, it's not just any emotional appeal to him. He has done, having considered all aspects of his, he's a responsible man. He brought this. But I said, as a captain of a ship, if the ship has run into troubled waters, I think it is also, he's taken moral responsibility of having navigated the ship in these waters. But then it's also his responsibility to see the ship to the safer shores. He should have at least tried and put it there. Like, once we are in an established position, then he could have, or somebody else could step in.
Your neighboring state, they point out that, you know, people like, you know, you all say that it was the elections that he's been very capable. But they all point out the fact that Rahul Gandhi didn't appoint the, you know, there was change of leadership. You have appointments of PCCs and all pending. That the Hoodas are very upset. There's a huge battle that's happening in your neighborhood, Haryana. Don't you think these are issues that
I think these are the issues where Mrs. Gandhi is required. I think this was
Rahul Gandhi failed.
Not failed. I think the situation, he must have had his own reasons. The situation could have been handled. And I think this kind of a very serious situation which Congress Party is going through, there's no time for experiments.
I
would say this was no time for experiments. The people who would believe in it, like you talked about Hoodaji, I think Hoodaji and likes of him, they have full faith in Mrs. Gandhi. And since they have had a working equation...
So you're saying the time was now for Mrs. Gandhi to come back?
I think it is, in a way, I think this is a right choice, because she instills confidence. She has faith of these senior leaders, and they know his working, they have worked, and they have kind of a confidence level, a comfort level working together.
The old guard has won then, Sunil Jakhar?
I would say there's always, you cannot be...
You're very honest about these things. Mm-hmm. I want to ask you. Do you accept there is a fight between the old guard and the new guard?
There's none. I think some of the names which were now being floated around were the more of like yes men of the old guard. I think they have been rejected. This kind of a vacuum had created, I would say it was a very embarrassing. I would not name anybody. Okay. They have all contributed to the party. Everybody has their own role. But I think amongst all these, there are vested interest fishing in troubled waters, I would say. There's no, it was not just one radia in corporate circles. I think there are radias in our party also who are wearing kurta pajamas, if not skirts. So I would say these people were being like all these, even BJP or other parties were trying to float names. I think this was not a very healthy situation. And I think it was better it is curbed now. And I think we have Mrs. Gandhi who will take care of the situation. And I think this is, in these present circumstances, I think it was required.
Tell us why you also have a very strong opinion, because no one else took names. You took names and spoke at the consultation. You have also strongly believe that Adhir Ranjan Choudhury, who is the leader of your party in Lok Sabha, that he shouldn't be the one.
No, I said he's a very, like a fighter. To make your presence felt in West Bengal, first the comrade, the kind of way the functioning was, now with the TMC, and he has made a mark for himself, and he's a street fighter. I have called him a street fighter, which is required today. The party needs it. Party has to go down to the streets. I think, as Rahul himself said, that we had become very comfortable all these years of being in power. We forgot how to be in opposition. That's what Adhir Ranjan represents. He was a street fighter and a man of conviction. You must understand the entire Congress party.
But,
just a second. Even Rahul Gandhiji was in favor of trying to patch up with, have an alliance with Mamata. But Adhir Ranjan stood his ground. I think he's a man of conviction, as he called him. But I think he would be better suited in the party, having a responsible role, leading an agitation, than to be. It's not a matter of everybody have their own strength and maybe not so strong points. I think articulation is not one of his strong points, but he's a street fighter and that's what party needs. I think people like Adhir Ranjan are the need of the hour today. Congress needs it. We have to fight it out, not in West Bengal. We have to fight it out in UP. We have to fight it out now in Haryana or Maharashtra. Everywhere we need Adhir Ranjan. Adhir Ranjan is indispensable, but in Lok Sabha, because we are left with very limited options of putting our views across. The kind of juggernaut BJP has let loose on media, I would say even corporate houses, all these media houses are controlled by the corporate houses, and the corporate houses are singing the tune of the BJP. So Parliament is still a forum where Lok Sabha TV or Rajya Sabha TV is still watched and people believe. And I think that's where a person who is more articulate.
Like Shashi Tharoor.
Yes, that's what I recommend.
Okay, the final question is about your state. You won. Punjab was the only state where the Congress did well. And yet we see one of your stars, that is Navjot Singh Sidhu, immediately fall out. He's not reported to work. So he's resigned. What went wrong there?
No, nothing went wrong. There's a style of functioning. And I think there has to be a cohesion in the chief minister is the first among the equals. And I think there has to be a trust. Like if you don't have the trust in the ministers and the chief ministership, I think that kind of this is a collective responsibility. And I think there were differences. So that differences have led to this.
But while the BJP is welcoming everyone, the Congress can't.
BJP, that's amazing. How can you wash your, in the moment is like this has become the modern day. I think they have new avatar of Ma Ganga. Anybody
you were
comes
supposed
from
to be joining
there,
as well.
Where? To the
there
BJP?
There was a rumor as well.
I've been in this position because of the Congress. I will remain a congressman. I can sit at home, but that's what I am. I am a congressman to my core.
Sunil Jakhar, thank you for speaking.
Thank you, Sunil. Thank you for talking to me. Thank you.
Thank you.